This is a very introductory level video for using Midjourney to create architectural concept designs. After you've joined Discord, and depending on your subscription level, you can create a direct message with the Midjourney chatbot. To start a prompt, you simply type /imagine or select it from the pop-up list. You'll then input your prompt, submit it, and wait for the options to render. Again, depending on your subscription level, rendering times will vary. There's a lot of great resources online that explain how the different descriptive words affect the outcome of the image. There are input techniques that allow you to control the weight of certain descriptive words in your prompt, and modifiers that you can add to the end of your prompt that allow you to control things such as the aspect ratio. When the rendering is complete, you can select it to enlarge and review your options 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can then decide if you'd like to upscale any of the four options, resubmit the prompt, or create variations on any of the four options. In this case, I'll select a few to create variations and explore the outcomes. With each variation, you'll receive a set of four new images in the theme of the original. Again, you have the option to enlarge the image to review and decide to either upscale, resubmit, or create variations on any of these options. In this case, I'll select one image from each of these variations to see how they develop when more detail is added. Once the images are complete, you can enlarge them to review the details and decide if they are worth developing further. Sometimes the images will contain odd figures or distorted perspectives. But when you find an image that you like, you can then decide to continue making variations or create a light upscale redo, which re-renders the image with a different algorithm. For reference, the algorithm that re-renders the light upscale redo tends to soften and omit details from the original. Again, all variations are in theme with the original, but now with more details. And you can continue to refine your design through this selective process by creating variations, upscaling, and resubmitting your design. This is obviously a very specific process, and it's destined to change to become more user-friendly. I can imagine architectural modeling software adopting this method of text-to-action technique for developing massing or even detailing architectural features. Artificial intelligence and machine learning depend on reference information and goal orientation to produce the results we expect. Theoretically, if an AI is trained with a catalog of relevant details, it can produce a set of construction drawings for any building imaginable. But I believe this is where the gap exists, between a generation of architects and designers who were passionate about developing details, and a generation who expect any object imaginable to be simply manufactured through a digital fabrication process. This is also when the great feedback loop will begin, where AI content is generated in mass and resubmitted as data for it to develop from. It is our responsibility as designers to continue imagining outside the realm of current technological capabilities. We must also maintain our position in determining the goal orientation for current and all future technologies, and we ourselves should continue to imagine what that goal should be.